Welcome back to the News at Noon. If Beale Street Could Talk has already earned several awards, Matt Perrin shares his thoughts on the film in today's Monday Movie Musings.
Welcome to another Monday. We had a plethora of new releases this weekend. Winning the box office was the upside, which I wanted to see because I've heard good things, but there's also an argument that it's not as good as the French film it remade, and I didn't feel like throwing my hat into that debate. Replicants was a movie that I almost went and saw as a guilty pleasure, but had one of the worst openings for a film released in that many locations ever. So I decided to save my Keanu viewing for the next John Wick later this year. A Dog's Way Home looked like a nice feel-good flick, but Columbia finally saw the release of one of the Best Picture contenders, so I decided to check that out instead. And without any further ado, here's my take on If Beale Street Could Talk. Our film begins in 1970s Harlem with Tish and Fonny, played by Kiki Layne and Stephan James, respectively. They are two kids that have known each other since they were children, but recently figured out they were in love and became engaged. They hit a snag when Fonny is arrested for a crime that he didn't commit. Not long after his arrest, Tish finds out she is pregnant and rushes to the prison to tell him. She then has to tell her parents, who turn out to be way more supportive than she thought possible. And even though Fonny's father shares the sentiment, his mother, a holy roller, is thoroughly against the news. It now becomes imperative to get Fonny acquitted of these charges, and Tish and her family set out to do just that. Over narration, we then get inundated with flashbacks that fill in the blanks of all the events leading up to the present. We see Tish and Fonny discovering their love for each other. We see Fonny setting his eyes on the career of woodworking with a steady hand and a creative mind. We see him reconnect with an old friend fresh out of prison with an ironic sense of foreshadowing, since we know what is coming. As the movie progresses, we see how Fonny used to protect Tish and try to set up a future for their family. So now, with him unjustly behind bars, we see her trying to do the exact same for him, all the while embracing her pregnancy. We see how family comes together to fight for what's right, but at the same time, we see how the system of that time is completely stacked against them. We, as the audience, hold out hope for the happy ending that we aren't quite sure whether or not we're going to get. So, what to say about this one? Barry Jenkins has done it again. Much like Moonlight, he has created another visually stunning film that manages to completely draw you in while at the same time never allowing you to get too comfortable. It's amazing that this film is able to make you question humanity itself in one breath, and in the next, show you the strength that we are capable of in the lowest of circumstances. It's one of those films that makes you go, I can't believe that people were railroaded like that back then. Then your next thought is, wait, have things actually changed that much? Yes, I know a movie that gets you thinking might shy some people away, but a movie that gets people talking is usually one that's worth seeing. Not enough can be said about the cast itself. Our two main characters are fantastic in their roles, but Tish's parents, played by Regina King and Coleman Domingo, really stand out for their performances. Of course, with a comedy background, my favorite was Tiana Paris as the sister whose lines kept me laughing in the most serious of moments. All in all, just a very good film that is deserving of the nomination when it inevitably comes in a little over a week now. Even the narration, which, like I said last week, is what took me right out of Vice, works well in this film, and in fact, I wish it had been just a little bit louder. You just have to get past a bit of a slow pace at times, but all in all, definitely one worth checking out. This has been your Monday Movie Musing. Back to you.
All right, and stick with us. Tyler has one last look at your forecast after the break.